is the government actually scared that social media is actually not curbed, or is it not watchdog sort of a thing? And is the government actually trying to do that?
Social media reaches only 12% of the population. That's the internet penetration in our country, 12%. But it can be replicated very easily in other forums. Once some people saw it and got inflamed, they in turn spread that message of hatred down the chain, and by SMS and other means, they started threatening people from the Northeast, till a point was reached where these people panicked and fled, went back to the Northeast, leaving their homes and their livelihoods. So a social media campaign actually changed the lives of many Indians. And obviously the government is very worried about that sort of thing. By the time the government figured out what was going on and tried to react, it was too late. And on social media, things go viral very quickly. On the contrary, the Chinese employ 40,000 cyber police to monitor every site that says anything like this. My gosh, I mean, there is no comparison.
Facebook is actually, people say it degrades your life, you know, it degrades your soul, it degrades your... I personally don't feel it. I feel it actually evolves you as a person if you, you know, choose it, if you know what you have to do with it. Like, if you know what you have to do with it. It's like, you know, a product is bought, it's like with a leaflet. There's a list of do's and don'ts. If you do the list of do's correctly, you get the product right. And Facebook is that. It's a tool where you have to use it in the right way.
Any public tool like that, is that anybody can distill it for information? I'm sure that there are people inventing search engines to go through Facebook posts and Twitter posts and find out about people they want to find out.
See, Facebook is very personal.
Right.
And what you do personally is not what you might be professionally. So I think it's a bit unfair.
It's unfair, but that's the world, isn't it?
Yeah, but I'm putting this on television.
Right.
I'm a fun-loving person personally, but that doesn't mean I'm not professional.
You also said in 2009 that politicians will have to get very serious about Twitter, or not the exact words.
No.
And recently, New Media in New Delhi, you repeated that.
In 2009, when I first made that statement, there was all this hostility to me, starting with the mainstream media, which made the rest of the conventional politicians back off. And so they all started saying, in fact, Venkaiah Naidu, then the president of the BJP, said, too much tweeting can lead to quitting, which turned out to be quite prescient, actually. But when that happened...
Did he tweet that?
And I was interviewed about... I just basically... No, he wasn't on Twitter, so he wouldn't tweet that. So I said, look, you know, being an early adopter, a pioneer, is always dangerous in any field. But the fact is, I said, within 10 years, every major politician in India will be tweeting.
One of the differentiation between humankind and animals is our power of speech. We talk. Now, with Facebook and tweeting becoming an exercise of the fingers, you think another 200 years from now, we lose the power of speech from now?
No, in fact, I think the professors will make the opposite case. Uh-huh. They'll say that the old days when people used to read much more and much greater length and depth, they spoke in a more knowledgeable way, but that now that you are actually on Twitter and other short forms of communication, the oral communication is likely to outstrip serious written communication because no one has the attention span to read anything very long. Mm. So, I mean, I think that that would be more likely to be the counter argument. Besides, social media can be used to put out videotapes of people speaking, audio tapes of people speaking. Yeah. So it's not as if the spoken word disappears.
We are not going to forget
but
how to
talk. But I think it's
killing
the English language for sure. Because
everything's
become shortened and no one has any regard for grammar or anything of that sort, which is sad.
She's right that the temptation to do that is great. I mean, because of the 140 character limit on Twitter, it's a place where lots of words are mangled. You know, if I express a thought in the words that I find best, and then I discover almost always that it's longer than 140 characters.
Absolutely.
I have to then trim. So first I try and trim it. So before becomes B and the letter number four. Before. So that saves four characters, you see.
But it kills English.
No, but that's still readable. But then what you start having to do is if the way you're expressing the thought is too long, then you have to express it in a less elegant way in order to get the thought across in the character. So Twitter is more of an enemy of the English language, but on Facebook you can say as much as you like. Yeah.
Would you vote because somebody has a very nice campaign on social media networks?
See, like she said, what's most important is the personality. It's not whether you have an account here or an account there. It's the personality that matters.
You will vote for Shashi Tharoor.
Absolutely.
'Somebody put out a picture from a movie in the 90s or something, one of Aamir Khan's early movies called Andaz Apna Apna. There's a picture of four people and one of them, they decided looks like me. So they started putting it out on Facebook and Twitter, Shashi Tharoor's first movie from his teenage days. And it wasn't me. I was in America working, I mean, I was in the United Nations working for refugees or something at that time. I wasn't sitting in a still in Andaz Apna. That went on for 3-4 weeks and I had to keep on replying saying that's not me, not me. And then I hope that people who have come from Facebook will also say this on Facebook. But sometimes 9 months later, this thing will still pop up again. And that's the enduring nature of internet myths.
Have you ever felt scared clicking on like on a Facebook page because you might get arrested, like those two girls did?
Frankly speaking, it is there at the back of your mind. There's always cautiousness in your mind. I always wonder that, you know, should I click like or not? But yes, I do have that kind of fear, like, so I don't go for such things, which, you know, which lead to any kind of problems or anything. So I just try to avoid it.
Where do you see the social media, say, 15 years from now or 20 years from now? You think it's a fad that will die out?
Don't forget that all the modern means of communication that have come in have not completely replaced the previous ones, they've added on. So that, you know, letter writing did not die with the telegrams did not die when the fax machines came, the fax machines have not died with the invention of emails have not died with the invention of Facebook and Twitter. And of course, throughout all this, I forgot to mention the phones where we can still talk to each other. So each thing gets added on. I would say this is going to be an extremely important means of communication. And in India, one very exciting prospect would be that with the advent of 4G and the next technologies beyond that, and with cheaply available mobile phones that have significant internet capacity, that the internet revolution in India, when we go from, say, 12% penetration to 60 or 65% penetration, will be on mobile phones that are internet-enabled. And when that happens, then truly Aam Aadmi will be on the internet.
So do you personally think that you're too addicted on Twitter?
I would agree that there are times when it takes more time than I intend to give it. Most of the time on truly busy days, I usually only tweet, for example, between meetings, I'm in a car going from one place to another, I'll tweet. So I don't allow it to take over my day. But there are times when I come back at the end of a long day, sit down at the computer to see what's on Twitter because I've been too busy during the day, and then suddenly an hour has gone by, and really that's an hour that has been subtracted from my sleep. So yes, you're right. I mean, one could back off a little bit. And so I'm sure at some point the time will come when I'll slow down. But right now, I think I'm still on that treadmill.
I think social is primarily about people. People like you, people like me, everyone that makes it, right? So it's a collaboration. So how do you think that public, private, everyone can collaborate and make the best out of this?
Now, I think the government certainly has every interest in a free internet. We are a democracy. We are trying to create a safe, open space. But it should also be safe from abuse, from pornography, from hate media, inflammatory incitement. Because the truth is that those things can actually harm people. You want to protect a space that actually is good for everyone. You don't want it to, at the same time, be available to those who would harm other people's interests.
Shashi Tharoor, thank you so much. And three young panelists today, thank you so much. I think you must have also liked it too, all you young people out there. Do write to us if you like it. But most of all, do not forget to be back to watch the next episode of this show at the same time, same day, next week. Until then, this is your host, MP Joseph, signing off on Asianet News Youth Express.